or the real love.
Yeah.
Let's just do that.
Okay.
I mean, you too. Seems to be.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me no more. Did you film that? You should do that, put it on there.
All right, so what is, you were talking yesterday about love and the different forms of love, and there's a, almost like a virtual love that's not really love that we all, that the culture has adopted us to and that we have to follow, and that's why there's so many divorces and so many bad marriages.
Yeah, I mean, ultimately the kind of Hollywoodized love, if I can use that word, this kind of climactic movie story where you have, you know, this man or woman who ends up meeting another person of the opposite gender, you know, which, by the way, is quite interesting in terms of the homosexual agenda, and I'll get into that into a second. But
we can't wait for that one.
Yeah. I think the whole notion of the Hollywood version of love, that's what I'm trying to say. This kind of beginning to end, where no matter how bad things are, it always ends up happy, either they're married or things are always promised. You know, one of my favorite movies is 500 Days of Summer. It's an extremely postmodern view of love, in that you have this story of these two people who traditionally, you know, it follows the narrative arc of there's man who meets a girl, they fall in love, but it actually doesn't end that way. You know, she ends up finding someone else who might possibly be perfect for her. Again, another problem. This whole notion of perfect love, which is really depressing when you think about it. It ends with the possibility of a happy ending, but never a promise of a happy ending. There's this point, and I think it illustrates what I'm trying to get at in the movie, about how love has become very pornographic and virtual. And pornographic in the sense that it's literally exceeded itself, that actually to the point where love, in the traditional sense, doesn't exist anymore. And so we're always relying on the pornographic sense of love, or the virtual sense of love. So there's this point where the main character, played by Joseph Gordon-Levitt, who goes up to meet Zoe Deschanel. And what ends up happening is there's a point in the movie where the screen splits down the middle, and you have reality, and then you have the ideal, what he hopes is going to happen. So he goes upstairs, and spoiler alert for those who haven't watched it, he goes upstairs, and in reality, she's very distant, she isn't interested in him romantically, it's more of kind of a platonic relationship going on. In the ideal sense, she's very interested, and the screen removes the split once he sees an engagement ring on her finger, as if like, oh my gosh, reality now has entered, you know, into his view. And this is for me what I call virtual love, is that we bring the ideal expectations, we bring our ideal hopes into a relationship, into a marriage, right? And I think that's the problem, is that to me, true love is the ability to say, you know what, there's days that you're probably not gonna look so beautiful to me. There are days that you probably are gonna have maybe even zits on your face, or there are days that you're just gonna tick me off, but I still love you. That and to me, that's and I don't like to use this word, but that's true love. That's this notion of saying, you know what, I'm gonna love you through your shit, and that's what makes you perfect, you know.